I'm only 17 years old, feeling good and looking good, working out, training hard, because I want to be a fighter. I want to be able to step in the ring and win a match. Those are my dreams, those are my goals, to be a Puerto Rican fighter. Raising me and my brother. I didn't know much of my father as a little kid. So when I was in school, I was getting bullied around all the time by other kids. Maybe because of my culture, my language, or because I was a little skinny, wimpy kid. I had to learn how to defend myself. I had to learn how to fight. Or I had to accept to get beat up by some other kids. in school. Wow, 20 years passed by so fast, and it seemed like yesterday when I wanted to be a fighter. It seemed like yesterday when I was just a kid, all cut up, looking good, strong, fast. The time goes by so fast, I didn't even realize. Now I'm a little bit heavier, and now it's a little bit difficult for me to do what I did when I was younger. But you know, I should have stayed in the game. I should have stayed in the sport. I should have followed my dreams. But I got involved in things I should have not got involved in. In La Calle, in the streets, doing other things, to hang out, to have a good time, not dedicating myself no more to the workout or to the training. We all fall. We all have our days. And when we do fall, some of us stand up, but some of us just keep dropping back down. Keep getting knocked out over and over again. Because life itself is a big fight. And I was fighting with my own self. I was fighting against drugs, women, hanging out with the wrong people. With people that even later on in life said they wanted to shoot me. Who were my friends? I didn't have no friends. I was just falling all the time, making the same mistake over and over again. But I just kept on trying. This is my fight. My own life is a fight. Why should I be in a gym somewhere dropping some sweat? Working out just to get beat down again? Man, I'm tired of that. That's kind of boring now. I don't need to get beat down over and over again. So this is what I do. I get what I want to get. I steal what I want to steal. That's right. I take it, and it's mine. If I take it, it's going with me. One day, I even went to a fish store and stole me a nice gold fish. Yeah, because I take anything I want to take. Electronics, DVDs, cameras, camcorders, GPI, whatever it is, I'll take it. Because I'm smart, I'm slick, and I can run. I learned that in the gym. Yeah, you know, I don't need to keep going to the gym no more. I do this, and I have fun. I have a big old rush, adrenaline, and all those feelings that I won, that I wasn't caught. This is what I win. This is my trophy. That's what I call it. I call it my trophy when I run. I got me something. I'm running with it. And you can't catch me. Ha! That's how good I am. I'm good at this. So why not keep doing it? I'll even steal food if I'm hungry. Yeah, a man gotta eat. So I take food and I eat it. Oh, that's what I do now. You can't catch me. You can't even see me. It's not like in the ring. Nah, I'm out here now. This is my place. This is how I do things out here. Yeah, then I could sell it. Or maybe I could just trade in for some weed. Get high, get some drugs. You know? I'll give it to a nice young lady. Give her a little present. A nice camcorder, a camera. You know, girls like when you give them things, so I gotta give them a little something, something. That way I can keep them happy. They think I got money like that. But you know, I gotta play it off my way. I gotta play it off.
Yo, manager. Man, what you doing, man? I don't want to come in, man. You don't want to bring me here. I don't want to come in, man.
Now this never supposed to happen, because I didn't do it.
I'll explain to you what's going on.
You should have thought about that when you were out there stealing and smoking weed.
Yeah, I do.
You see what I'm saying?
And you have a baby that'll be in there?
I feel you, but, you know, you can't be out there doing all that.
What's my baby, man? My baby, so you have kids?
Yeah, but you have to be responsible and not be going out there and doing the things that you're doing.
I don't hurt nobody, man. I just smoke my weed, that's all.
But you're stealing for people.
Even Walmart, it was not people, it's Walmart.
Well, it's still stealing.
But you got a whole bunch of money anyway.
But you still don't steal from them. How would you like if someone came over to your house and stole stuff?
I know. I got a bat.
Just because it's Walmart don't mean You can just go in there and pick up stuff without paying for it.
Everybody do. You never took nothing. I bet you took something for when you was a little kid. Yeah, you see? Yeah, we all take something.
But you've taken a lot of things.
One time.
We were looking for you for
a couple weeks now. It was one time.
Right, that's what you say.
I don't want to talk to you.
You don't want to talk to me anymore?
Nope.
You want your order?
Yeah.
You think so? It's going to be like that?
You think I'm going to talk to me anymore?
You want to be like that?
Mm-hmm.
Huh?
Every time I talk to you, woman, you got charged. You got charged. You know what I'm talking about?
I'm your only friend right now. I'm your only friend right now.
You ain't got no friend in this world. Ain't nobody from this world. Everybody got you trying to get your back, trying to stab you. Ain't nobody a friend. Who you talking about? Who's your friend? I don't want to talk to you.
Why don't you want to talk?
No.
Well, then if you don't want to talk, I guess you can go back in the cell. And you can sit there and think about it. I'll go up and type the charges.
Now I fought a lot of people and a lot of things, but I can't fight this man. He's a popo, he's cops. Cops always win. They always do what they do, and what they say is relax.
Relax. You hear me? You gonna relax? Because you don't want to make it hard on yourself.
Okay.
Alright? You want to relax?
Yeah.
Alright, we'll go out here to the slave town. Yeah. Alright? And you're going to take care of some paperwork. And you're going to calm down. You hear me?
Your mind start thinking a whole bunch of crazy stuff. Just rushing right through your mind. Cause you don't know what's gonna happen to you now. You got caught.
Go on in here.
Alright. Y de fieras salvajes, como no. Ya no hay quien salga loco de contento. Donde quiera te espera lo peor. Donde quiera te espera lo peor. Juanito Alimaña, con mucha maña, llega al mostrador. Saca su cuchillo sin preocupación. Dice que le entreguen la registradora. Saca los billetes, saca un pistolón. ¡Pum! Sale como el viento en su disparada. Y aunque ya lo vieron, nadie ha visto nada. Juanito Alimaña va a la fechoría, se toma su caña, fabrica su orgía. La gente le temen porque esté cuidado. Va a meterle mano, hay que ser un bravo. Si lo meten preso, sale al otro día. Porque un primo suyo está en la policía. Juanito Alimaña, si tiene maña, es malicia viva. Y siempre se alinea con el que está arriba. Y aunque a medio mundo le robó su plata, todos lo comentan, nadie lo delata. Y aunque a todo el mundo
you could do when you went here,
le robó la
is
plata,
think
todos
and
lo
think.
Comentan.
And that's all I do, to try to figure out, where did I go wrong? How did I start being so crazy with my crazy self? How did I start stealing and taking stuff? Man, I fell in too deep. Man, what I do now is drugs. I'm chilling though, you know. Looking for some ladies. I'm feeling good, looking good. But it's like I'm stuck. It's like I lost. I lost my family. I lost my wife. I lost my kids. Ain't got no friends. So that's why I do what I do. To try to find some happiness. Some kind of pleasure. since I fell, it seems like I'm stuck. And I keep doing the same thing over and over again, falling into the same old mess, same old garbage. This is crazy. This is my life. It's whack. But anyway, life goes on, and I got to just keep on moving. Keep moving side to side, do my thing, go to the club, find some ladies, do whatever I gotta do, just to find some pleasure, find a big old rush, stay a little bit happy at least. I could do whatever I wanna do, because I'm free to do so. I could talk to whatever girl I wanna talk to. I ain't got one by my side, so ain't nobody gonna say nothing to me if I talk to her or her or her. Yeah, I just go chill, drink my beer, smoke some weed. Ain't nobody gonna mess with me. I got this. I got some boys, they say they my boys, but you know, really not like that. Sometimes I wish that I could just change my life, that I could get back into doing some road work, training. I wish I could get back into the gym again. That's what I need to do. I need to change my life. My life is up to no good, and I'm not up to no good. I need a change. I need a change in my life. One day.
They call me Joe, you know, on the streets, you know what I'm saying? But I don't even tell people my name.
What?
I just want to listen to music and I tell them, you know. But ain't nobody gonna say nothing to me because, you know, I'm just working out. Nice, sounds nice. Wow. You know, I like church, but I don't want to be
Sé dónde estuvo.
say with me.
Okay.
Say, Jesus.
Jesus.
Come to my life.
Please come to my life.
I accept you.
I accept you.
As my personal savior.
As my personal savior.
Forgive all my sins.
Forgive all my sins.
And from today.
And from today.
And on.
And on.
I will be your servant.
I will be your servant.
And I will love you.
And I will love you.
With all my life.
With all my life.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Get in your knees. I'm going to pray for you, so God will bless you. He will bless your family. He will bless everything that you are. Oh God, look this life that he was confused. But now, he has come to you. And I have given you, oh Shah, my life. The best that I have, that is you, Lord. I ask you, Lord, that you write his name in the book of life. And from now on, all the pain, all the tribulation, all temptation, all confusion, I rebuke it in the name of Jesus from his life and establish your kingdom, a kingdom of love, a kingdom of peace, a kingdom of happiness. Oh God, bless this life, bless this man. Oh Lord, thank you, because the heavens are open, the gates of heaven have come, and even blessing him today with all the blessings of heaven. Oh, Shamakia Lamanaya. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for coming to this life. And from now on, when he get up from his sleep, he's not going to be confused anymore. He's not going to be very confused. It's not going to be like he's trying to kill himself. From now on, when he get up, he'll be like you. In your name, he will be a champion. Oh, when he raised up, all from the fire of life, he's been fighting from a love, from the strength, all from evil, from violence. But when he get up from his knee today, he will be a champion. He will be walking with a champion, because you are a champion, Lord, and you make him a champion in the name of Jesus. Amen. Get up, champion. You are a champion. You are a champion in Jesus Christ. You are.
Cristo, a tu lado estará, pelea y no te detenga. Cristo, a tu lado estará, amigo. Jesús te está llamando, date prisa, Él te está esperando. Ya no tienes que llorar y no tienes que sufrir más. Amigo, Jesús te está llamando. La vida ha sido dura para ti. Haya de sufrir, porque llorar y llorar en tu amarga soledad. Pelea y no te detenga. Pelea, amigo, vuelve y comienza.
Aleluya.
Aquí hay que luchar.
Your God.
No se puede desmayar.
I bless you.
Si te rindes, morirás.
I'm blessed, Daniel, Lucito.
Te podrás levantar. Acuérdate.
Mira. Amen. Yes. Yes, amen.
Ha querido destruirte una vez más. Pelea y no te detengas. Cántalo conmigo. Cristo, Cristo, a tu lado estará, a tu lado estará. Pelea, pelea y no te detengas, y no te detengas. Cristo, a tu lado.
estará. Hermano, a veces tiene el momento que tienes que llorar. Ya no puedes caminar y la fuerza ya no te da. En este camino vienen pruebas y tormentas por doquier. Nuestra mente se turba y se tiende a desmayar. Aleluya, aquí hay que luchar. ¡Óyelo bien! No se puede desmayar. ¡Hermana! Si te rindes morirás. Jamás te podrás levantar. ¡Mira! Acuérdate. Mira cómo Satanás ha querido destruirte una vez más. Pelea y no te detengas. Cántalo, Cristo. A tu lado estará. A tu lado estará. Pelea.
Pelea.
¿Cómo estás?
¿Estamos bien?
Bien, bien.
Yo soy el pastor Claudio Carrasco.
Ajá.
Y vengo para hablar contigo un poquito.
Sí, sí, ¿cómo no? ¿Cómo no?
He sabido que tú has entregado tu corazón al Señor.
Bueno, lo tuve que hacer ya que vivía una vida desordenada y en la carrera que estaba yo, en el boxeo, no iba para ningún lado. Iba cayendo hacia abajo todo el tiempo.
Cuéntame un poquito, ¿cómo fue ese encuentro con el Señor?
Bueno, fue difícil porque la manera que yo vivía, buscando el atletismo, el boxeo, pero la misma vez buscando la calle, la droga y cogiendo con diferentes personas, pues no fue fácil, tuve que tomar una decisión. O me quedo en la calle del piso tirado, o busco una solución. Y no había ninguna solución. Pues un día pasé a una iglesia y pues, le entregué mi corazón a Jesucristo. Y eso fue lo más lindo que yo he hecho, porque ahora siento como nueva fuerza, ahora quiero levantarme como boxeador, como atleta otra vez. Quiero demostrarme a mí mismo primero que yo puedo, porque tengo toda fuerza en el que me restauró, que se llama Jesucristo.
¿Cómo tú ves ahora el momento que tú estás viviendo en Dios y cómo tú miras el tiempo pasado? ¿Qué diferencia tú puedes ver en esos tiempos?
Bueno, en el tiempo pasado yo veía que había mucha negatividad. Todo era negativo en mi vida, todo era hacia abajo. Yo trataba de salir adelante, pero caía. Trataba de no robar o de no hacer droga, pero volvía y caía. Como que había una persona dominándome. Y hoy entiendo que esa persona era Satanás. Ella me quería destruir. Pero que ahora veo que mi vida, pues, aunque pase lo que pase en el mundo, vivo feliz porque sé que hay una respuesta en Jesucristo.
Amen.
Y sé que ya yo no me voy a perder.
Okay.
Vivía ese tiempo pensando que todo era relajo y vacilón, que si dinero, que si party. Pero ahora sé que algún día me voy a ir con el Señor y estoy feliz.
Amen. ¿Qué tiempo hace que tú conociste al Señor?
Ya yo llevo como algunos aproximadamente 3 años que me reconcilié con el Señor. Y desde que lo hice, mi vida ha cambiado totalmente. Quiero levantarme, quiero prosperar. Quiero demostrarle a mucha gente que me criticaron, me señalaron de la vida que yo vivía. Quiero enseñarle que ya yo no soy esa persona.
Okay.
Que ya yo soy una persona mucho mejor, que soy una persona cambiada. Y quiero decirle a muchos jóvenes que mira, en Cristo podemos seguir adelante. En Cristo podemos ganar y ser vencedores y más que vencedores. Pero si seguimos esa vida de jangueo todo el tiempo, vamos a perder.
Ahora, después que tú estás viviendo esta nueva experiencia en Cristo Jesús, hay muchos jóvenes allí en las calles que están metidos en las drogas, que están metidos en el alcoholismo, que están metidos en las gangas, en el vandalismo. ¿Qué consejo tú tienes para todos esos jóvenes que en este momento están perdidos sin Cristo y sin esperanza allá afuera?
Bueno, yo creo que solamente hay una cosa que cada ser humano debe de hacer. Reconocer que solo él no puede hacer nada, que solamente con su propia fuerza vamos a caer. Pero si un día nosotros reconocemos que somos pecadores y vamos a una iglesia y aceptamos a Jesucristo como nuestro Salvador, que Él murió en la cruz por nosotros, aceptamos el sacrificio, entonces Él viene a nuestro corazón y nos cambia. Entonces podemos tener metas y lograr nuestras metas y triunfar en la vida y tener victoria. Pero la juventud hoy en día no quiere esa vida, quiere estar en el vacilón hasta que algo malo le pase. Y yo tuve que esperar que algo malo me sucediera a mí para reconocer que estaba perdido y que necesitaba a Cristo en mi vida.
Si hay algún joven que necesite ayuda, ayuda profesional, ayuda psicológica, física, puede apersonarse, puede acercarse a ti para que tú le puedas ayudar en cualquier asunto.
Sí, eso es lo que yo busco hacer ahora con mi vida, demostrarle a la gente que mira, yo estoy lleno de tatuajes, yo era así y ahora soy diferente porque Cristo me cambió. Y eso es lo que yo busco, demostrándole a la juventud que puede haber un cambio, no importa la crisis en su hogar, no importa el la vida que ellos han tenido en el pasado, si las gangas, si las mujeres, la droga, la cárcel, que Cristo puede cambiarlo. Yo quiero ayudarle a esos jóvenes que cambien su vida, mirándome a mí, que ellos digan, si él lo hizo, yo también lo puedo hacer, porque en Cristo no hay nada imposible para él.
Pues bien, yo quería pues hacerte estas preguntas,
okay,
muy amable de tu parte,
okay.
Y recuérdate que estamos contigo y en lo que podamos ayudarte, amén, estamos ahí para ti.
Aquí
estamos, nosotros estamos como pastor asociado en la iglesia del 25 de la North Lyon Street, que es la que pastorea la reverenda Swinda Melo. Ahí estamos a tu disposición, cualquier cosa podemos ayudarnos.
Esa es la que queda por la...
What's up, fellas? I know y'all hanging out, having a good time. My name is Jose. I do the same thing y'all doing right now. Hanging out with the boys, chilling, drinking, smoking my weed. I did all that stuff, but today, I'm going to show you something else that I did in my life. I had to change my life, because this was my life. That was me, believe it or not. That's why I'm showing you all these pictures right here. But y'all can believe by seeing what I was. Now I dedicate my life to Jesus Christ. I serve Jesus Christ because my life was going down to hell. The way I was living, people were telling me they wanted to shoot me. One more from Puerto Rico saying they'll go out there and go alone. And now, I live a peaceful life. I don't have to worry about the streets anymore. Somebody want to come get me, I'm free now. I'm free because my life is free. My heart is at peace with God. And I know y'all can keep doing what y'all doing, and I'm not going to obligate nobody to stop what y'all doing, because I did it too. When it comes from the heart, when y'all want to make that change, y'all make that change, y'all come to Jesus Christ. So believe it or not, this was me. Check it out. A lot of people don't believe it, but I even change my experience every day to go steal, rob, and go catch me. But now I live a different life. Like I said, I don't have to go steal. I don't have to go do drugs. I don't have to do this hanging out no more. I don't have to watch my back because now God got my back. But I'm saying this right now, you know why? Because I leave this place right now. If I leave from here thinking about all y'all young kids going out there hanging out and somebody might shoot you or kill you, how am I going to feel? And I can tell you about it. I'm going to feel bad. I knew a young kid down the street by Queen Street. Good boxing. He was boxing. Okay? And guess what? He was fighting in the street. Somebody came shot him up. He's dead now. Young kid, 21 years old. Happens every day. It can happen to any one of you. I could have been there too. That's what I want to say. God bless you guys. Enjoy your day. Peace.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you for coming out to the Ritz Casino in beautiful Hollywood, California for another one of Barry Stump's famous boxing promotions. I have a fighter here tonight, and I'm glad I got a chance to get to the mic first because I don't need to do more talking after I get done with this, and I let my fighter do the talking for me. I've got my fighter here, Jose Arroyo, top 10 world caliber fighter, had a year off, had a little difficulty with some things, making a comeback here, and we got some punk over here, some corn salad. I mean, it's my promotion, I'm paying the guy, but it's just, you know, it's just boxing. It's boxing, and you know, the show's gonna sell itself. It's to me, it's the perfect guy. He's sitting there looking like all tough, and his trainer looking like he knows what he's doing too. But these guys, they don't have a clue. It's a rough sport, and you know, what do you call him, the destroyer? What do you call him, the destroyer?
Right.
I already seen. They already had the casino's name on the bottom of the shoes for advertisement. Somebody goes under the floor. You know what I mean?
Shit.
I ain't worried about this cat at all. And this kid here, I dropped probably more balls on the floor this guy would wrap in somebody's hands, you know? I got confidence in the player.
Right. Yeah.
And his talk, I just feel you're making a bad move. God bless you. I hope you got another career. You know what I mean? You don't get too hurt.
Right, yeah.
So, but I do want to thank you for sacrificing yourself coming to be a part of my promotion. My boy here is, you're going to feel it. You're going to feel it. That's what I got to say right now. These guys want to have your turn tonight. Come up and talk whatever bull you think you can run.
Yeah. I got it. I want to thank you guys for coming out here. I know it's been a real challenge for me, myself, to get up back on my feet, to face this guy right here, calling himself the Destroyer. A long time ago, I felt like I was about to be destroyed by the streets, by the drugs hanging out. But you know who I found in my life? I found Jesus Christ. And now I ain't gonna let the devil destroy me. And I ain't gonna let this punk right here try to destroy me. That's right, I call myself Real Fear. I call myself Real Fear because I have the fear of God in my life. A real man has real fear. When you fear God, that's real.
Amen.
That's real. And the way I lived my life in the street, just hanging out, doing drugs, stealing, robbing, I was up to no good. I was about to get killed. But today I'm going to prove to a whole bunch of people, and especially myself, that I'm going to get on my feet. And because of the grace of God, I am here. And I also want to thank my coach, Barry Stump, Barry Stump Promotions, for this opportunity. We don't have a lot of opportunities in life. Young man, you don't have opportunities in life unless you go out and get it. You could be out on the street, pushing people around like yourself. People do things for the wrong reasons a lot of times. But I'll tell you that when I get in the ring, I got a little something for you. See this right here? This is how you can sound. That's right. Feel it.
We'll see.
Your day is coming.
We'll see.
Because you've been talking a lot of trash.
Okay.
Your day is coming. I ain't got nothing else to say, just listen. That's you.
Talked a little rough about the Destroyer, but I am happy he's part of this. He's part of boxing. And he's still a man who's showing up in the ring. You know what I mean? And most of my anger is with guy, the way he lives his life sometimes, Destroyer, Destroyer this, Destroyer that. I don't know, I don't like the name of Destroyer. Right. But they don't mean nothing to me.
It is the Destroyer.
The Destroyer, right.
Yeah.
Yeah, they made the Titanic a Destroyer too. You saw what happens at it sunk.
That's right.
And going down like the Titanic.
You're going down. You're going down. You got to stay.
Have a seat over here.
Wait for the rain.
I'm going to give my man a chance to talk, but he is part of the promotions. I'm happy. You know, good thing, you know, God was on our side here because I got a good kid that I took back off the streets. He ran away from me from years ago, and he's back now. You know, he's back. He came back. He knew where good things were happening.
Right.
And this guy here, you know, we're giving this guy an opportunity of a lifetime.
No, it's his guy. It's the Destroyer.
Well, I'll tell you what. Thank God for my guy, because we sold the tickets. This guy couldn't sell nothing. People paying to see him get his head, see him get his butt beat. See him get his butt beat. He didn't have no fans at all. He just wanted to see him get beat, so I thank him for that, because he helped me sell a lot of tickets. He's going to see him get beat.
Yeah.
All right? So I'm going to give his people a chance to go talk and run their mouth, and but I do thank him, you know. I'm glad you passed the physical, you know what I mean?
Anytime,
boy. It's your opportunity up here. All right, man? Don't talk much shit on me, man. Don't have a trainer. Don't even bump into me up here.
Don't even bump
into
me.
You know what? I'm not going to talk too much because the trainer we did, he just committed. He did a good comeback, but the good comeback is to get destroyed. That's your name, that's what we are, the Destroyer. Never gonna talk too much. We're gonna see him in the ring. The action is gonna tell.
Yeah. Boom, boom, boom. Boom. What you got to say? What you got to say?
You got any balls?